I just wanted to talk about, well, what exactly are we referring to when we're talking about succulents? There's a lot of different kinds. Basically, they store water, usually in their leaves, maybe their stems, in some cases even roots, but it is a general rule they store it in their leaves and stems. Most of the time when you pull succulents out of their pot, you'll find that the roots are barely visible. There's just not much there. The roots are thin and few and far between sometimes. They're almost more like a fine spider web. They're just not real thick. They tend to be very shallow rooted. They live in areas that don't always get that much rain. So what they do is they keep their roots close to the surface so that when they do get a rain, they can catch it real quick before it evaporates off. Many of them are from deserts or from deserty coastal areas, inland deserts, hot deserts, cold deserts, every kind of desert. They come from all over the world, Africa, the Americas, even places in Europe, certain types. So they're very, very versatile, come from all over the world, generally don't have a whole lot of root. So, and that makes them very easy to work with. You can really pack them together into a pot. Pack them nice and close when you're putting multiples into a pot. You don't have to put a lot of space in between them other than what you think they might need for growing their leaves. But generally, even then, they get along pretty good. We store the water in, again, stems and leaves. In the case of the cactus, it's pretty much the stem or trunk or body of the plant, whatever you want to refer it to. A true cactus has no leaves. There are some similar things that look like cactus that do have leaves, like the euphorbia, but very, very similar and pretty much work on the same principles. This right here is a fat boy. I've got another one here. This is actually a saguaro, native to Arizona. Won't grow up here in Prescott outdoors year round because they're not cold hardy. They grow in southern Arizona where the elevations are lower. So something to keep in mind when choosing succulents, if you plan to keep them outdoors, you want to be asking, can this make it through winter? There are things that will, some types of cactus, some types of agave. There are some things that will go through, hens and chicks. They will go all the way through winter and be just fine. But if it's something that's low elevation, like the saguaro right here, it needs to come in for the winter. Some succulents, especially the ones that are rather inexpensive, are often just treated as annuals, just like you buy a petunia every year and throw it out at the end of the season. You can do the same thing with succulents. That way they always look the prettiest every year. So just like you would if you were planting any other kind of plant, mix in the premium mulch when you're doing it. And I would also recommend, if you've got the clay, which most of us do, I would also recommend gypsum. That helps to soften up the clay just a little bit to improve the drainage. And sometimes it's just enough to get you over the top. So when you have really poor drainage.